Our next speaker is Hal Schneider.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. My name is Hal Schneider. I am a resident of Forsyth County, and I'm here representing myself individually, although I like to think that I'm representing a silent majority of the county residents who are also customers of the Forsyth County Water Department. I am here to speak in opposition of the extension of the current water contract through October as proposed in Tuesday's work session. The current contract forces the county to purchase 4.5 million gallons of finished water from the city that on a normal day the county doesn't even need. The annual cost of this forced purchase is nearly $4 million. Extending the existing contract until October would cost the county residents about $200,000 per month, or a total of $1 million over what it would cost if Commissioner Levent's proposal were implemented. The argument is made that we must work on the water contract in conjunction with the service delivery strategy and loss negotiations because they are interdependent. I'm sorry, but that argument just doesn't hold water. Pun intended. First of all, getting the water contract in place before it expires completes that small piece of the service delivery strategy early, letting the board concentrate on other issues. Secondly, the water contract should not play any role in the loss list because the water rates already pay for the water services provided by the city. Including them in the loss split would be paying the city twice for the same services. The other argument that I've heard is that if we allow the contract to expire and the mayor raises the rates, how would the commissioners be able to explain to the county residents why water rates went up, which they might? That's really simple. Blame the mayor. He raised the rates. He'll be the one responsible. It's also been suggested that he could raise the raw water rate to make up the loss. He'd have to raise it from 10 cents per thousand gallons to $1 per thousand gallons to make up the reduction. It would be interesting to hear the mayor explain that increase to a judge. Letting the contract expire means the county would no longer be obligated to purchase any water that it doesn't need. While Commissioner Levent's proposal goes a long way to get the county to the position it needs to be in, I do not agree with paying one dime to the city for the $11 million bill that was sent in January at the behest of one of the commissioners here today. It is my understanding that the county attorney has already sent a letter to the mayor telling him that the county's position is that the county is not liable for the charges included in that bill. The city has been fleecing the county residents for the past 25 years to the tune of $12 million last year for excessive water charges, excessive loss, and loss splits. It is no wonder that the city has no debt and had $27 million in reserves at the end of 2010. They were able to pay the $17 million cost of the upgrade to their intake because they had been banking their excess profits from the county residents for years and had the cash on hand. The only reason that I can come up with, can I have one more minute, please?
No exception.
The only reason I can come up with for extending the existing contract is so that certain commissioners on this board will not have to be held accountable to the voters in July when they vote in favor of a contract that is good for the city and bad for the county. Extension is nothing but a political ploy to allow some commissioners to vote in favor of the city after the July elections without consequence. How about doing what is best for the county residents for a change? It is way past time for the county commissioners to stop allowing the tail to wag the dog. Thank you very much.
Thank you.